Hey kids, today we're making pan spam musubi. I've always wondered about this, you know, because I've seen it before. Now this doesn't call for the plastic wrap in the bottom, but I was thinking if this gets melted to the bottom, then it would be a waste of the seaweed, you know? So I'm going to place that plastic wrap under there. Now this is a recipe that's supposed to be made in a 9x13 pan. And I'm not going to make the entire dish as usual. So I'm gonna cut things down in size. So I have a much smaller pan here. Anyway, you're supposed to lay two of these sheets of seaweed down in the bottom of your pan. But I'm gonna modify as usual. I have the rice in the microwave in my Tupperware dish cooking right now. And once that's ready, we'll be fixing to go. I've got my pan ready on the stove, so we're gonna get the spam going soon. Alrighty, so I wiped it all out. We're just gonna toss this back in here. I'm gonna, oh actually, you know what, hang on a sec. Probably best if I allow this stuff to blend a little bit.
Hold on a second.
We have 1/4 cup of sugar, 2 tablespoons of mirin, and 4 tablespoons or 1/4 cup, same thing, of shoyu. And I'm gonna mix this up. I'm gonna make sure that the sugar is all nicely blended. Hope I didn't burn it. And let me turn this down a tad. I'm gonna put it on about medium. I just want it to simmer. Still having that sugar in there. There we go. Much better. Now, turn it down even lower. I'm going to put my spam in here and I'm going to let this just simmer until the liquid disappears. Pretty much. So keep your eye on it because it does contain sugar. It can burn. And there's my rice, nice and ready. Now I'll just set it on the side and let it steam for now. And we'll be back. I just remembered that I was supposed to half this, but I didn't. So the sauce is probably not going to boil down anytime soon and or be absorbed totally into the spam. So I'm just going to pull it out at some point and then just use it as is, because I was supposed to use 2 cans of spam in the whole recipe and this is only 1. Alright, so at this point you want to take half of your rice and you want to spread it out. This might be a little, whoa, danger Will Robinson, danger. That wasn't a really good start for this, was it? This is a little bit bigger pan than it probably should be for a half of a recipe. So I'm going to spread this out really, really thin. I probably should have made more rice, but it's all good. It's all good. Alrighty, so you spread out half of your rice. And you press it down so that it is even throughout. That's not uber even. Over there, is it? Then you're going to sprinkle the top with your furikake, which is your seasoned or furikake, sorry, which is your seasoned seaweed. And then you are going to place your lovely marinated spam on top of that. So let me go get that and do that. Okay, done. Then, okay, this is going to be a little bit harder. We're going to spread that second layer of rice. Should have made a whole lot more rice, right? Yep. And I'm going to even it out, just like I did with that first layer. I'm going to go take care of that. Second verse, same as the first, only this time it's in reverse. All right, so we sprinkle the furikake. And then we cover it with more of the nori. And of you go. We will cut it into rectangles. Pan, spam, musubi. Enjoy. I cut it into rectangles. It's time to grub. I'm just saying, too messy for me. Just give me back my regular spam musubi and I'd be happy. But I wanted to try this because I've had one at a party and it was, you know, same kind of deal. it's easy for the person making it, and it takes up less, like sushi and, seaweed, but, yeah, spring for the extra nori and just do it. Enjoy.